Honorable teachers and dear friends, this is a presentation on foodborne fungi. It is prepared and presented by Pallavi Ratha, Shipra Chauhan, K. Suman, V. Mounica, and D. Akshitha. So now let's start with a very basic question. What is a fungi? Fungi, also called molds, are ubiquitous in nature. Molds are multicellular organisms. A typical mold possesses hyphae, conidiophore, which consists of stalk, vesicle, stigmata, and conidia, that are also called spores. Their cell wall consists of a polymer called chitin. Fungi are quite well known in the food industry as spoilage-causing agents, although some are really helpful in the manufacturing of certain dairy products like cheese and fermented milk. Now let's have a look at some of very common foodborne fungi. First, let's start with Alternaria. Separate mycelia with conidiophores are found in this case. Large brown color conidia are formed with both cross and longitudinal septa and are variously shaped. They cause brown to black rots of stone apples and figs. They are also called field fungus that grows on wheat. Aspergillus. Chains of conidia are formed in this case. They appear yellow to green to black on various food items. Aflatoxin is produced by Aspergillus flavus and Aspergillus parasiticus. Aspergillus ocraceus produces 7 structurally related secondary metabolites. Next is Penicillium. It causes blue and green mold rots of citrus fruits. Penicillium roqueforti produces blue cheese. Some species produce citrinin, yellow rice toxin, ochratoxin A, rubratoxin B, and other mycotoxin. Penicillium is a well-known source of a very powerful antibiotic known as penicillin. Next is botrytis. They have long, slender, pigmented conidiophores. Mycelium is septate. Conidia is borne on apical shapes and are gray in color. They cause gray mold of citrus fruits. Next, let's come to Cladosporium. In this case, separate hypha with dark tree-like budding conidia are found. In culture, the growth is velvety and olive-colored to black. Cladosporium herbarium and Cladosporium cladosporides are two most common species that are found in food items. Next is Fusarium. In this case, extensive mycelium is produced that is found with cottony and a very light tinge of pink, red, purple or brown. In this case, separate fusiform to sickle-shaped conidia are formed. Large brown rot of citrus fruits and soft rot of figs are caused by fusarium. So, now we talk about another genus, that is Geotrichum. It is known as Odium lectus and Oospora lectus. They are yeast-like fungi and usually white in color. Their hyphae is septate and their reproduction occurs by formation of anthroconidia. Geotrichum candidum imparts flavor and aroma to many cheeses. They are responsible for spoilage of dairy cream. Now we talk about other genus, that is Monelia. Pink, grey or tan conidia are produced under this genus. Monelia cytophylla is the conidial stage of neurospora intermediate. They cause brown rot of peaches and moreover, they causes mummification of blueberries. We talk about another genus of fungi, that is Mucor. So, they are non-septate hyphae which gives rise to sporangiophores. Their condition described as whiskers of the weave and black spot of frozen mutton are caused by some species of Mucor genus. Now, we move to other genus, that is rhizopus. These rhizopus are non-septate hyphae
which give rise to stolons and rhizoids. The rhizobus stolonifer is a common species found in food, also referred to as bread mold. They cause watery soft rot of apples, pear, stone fruits, grapes, and produces pectinases. Rhizobus oligosporus is important in the food industry. So, here we end up with our genus of fungi. Now, let us talk about some common media used in fungal culture and their principles. So, the first media which we are going to talk is potato dextrose agar. This contains sugar dextrose as the carbohydrate source, which serve as a growth stimulant, and potato infusion that provides a nutrient base for luxuriant growth of most fungi. The other medium is seborrheic agar medium, that is the SD media. It is comprised of casein and animal tissues, which provide a nutritious source of amino acids and nitrogenous compounds for the growth of fungi and yeast. Dextrose is a fermentable carbohydrate incorporated in high concentration as carbon and as an energy source. Now, let us discuss about yeast glucose chloramphenicol agar. It is a nutrient medium that inhibits the growth of organisms other than yeast and molds due to the presence of chloramphenicol. Yeast extract provides basic nutrients essential for growth. Glucose is a carbon as well as energy source. Now, the other agar is Zipac agar, that is CZA agar. Zipac media is a solid, neutral, chemically defined medium containing sodium nitrate as the sole source of nitrogen. Fungi and bacteria capable of utilizing this inorganic source will grow. Sucrose is the energy source and the sole source of carbon. Now, the other media is malt agar. It contains malt extract, which provides the carbon, protein, nutrient sources required for organism growth. Agar is a solidifying agent. The acid pH of malt agar provides optimal growth of yeast and mold while inhibiting other bacterial growth. The last agar which is we going to discuss today is yeast and mold agar. It is based on the formulation described by Wickerham. The medium is recommended for the isolation and maintenance of yeast and molds. This agar may be rendered selective by the addition of acid to reduce the pH of the medium to pH 4. A suitable acid used is lactic acid.
Now, my topic is about the sources of fungal contamination and its control. Sources of fungal contamination in food and industry include: in food and dairy industry, contaminated water and unsanitary factory machineries can contribute significantly to fungal contamination. Human errors like unsanitary clothing of the personnel or poor handling of waste and unknown contaminants and poor microbial inception. Several favorable factors contribute to the growth of fungi, namely high moisture content, humid climate, warm temperature. The temperature ranges from 25 to 40 degrees Celsius, insect infestation and pest damage. Aerial spores. These spores are present in the air which are surrounding in the circulating atmosphere are also the potent contaminants. Next, what are the control measures for this fungal contamination? Okay, in fungal contamination, there are three types of control measures are there. They are physical treatment, chemical treatment, and the treatment with natural herbs and plants. Now, what are the physical treatment? After the crops have been harvested, drying of proper storage and suitable transportation of the commodities are of prime importance. Drying seeds and commodities to the safe moisture levels less than 9% for the peanut and less than 13.5% for corn cobs and etc. Maintenance of the container or warehouse at low temperature and humidity. Temperature and humidity plays a very key role for the fungus to growth. That's why we have to take the preventive measure in case of temperature and humidity. Keep out insects and pests from the storage. gamma irradiation of large scale commodities, it is also required in the control measures. Now come to the chemical treatment with synthetic fungicides. Organic acids, example acetic acid, propanoic acid, butyric acid, malonic acid, benzoic acid, sorbic acid, lactic acid, citric acid and their sodium salts. These are some of the examples of organic acid derivatives which are going to stop the growth of fungus. Benzoic acid derivatives, onitrobenzene, O-aminobenzoate, palmitoate, benzocyanin. These are the example for benzoic acid derivatives. And potassium sulfate and potassium fluoride, fumigant, ammonia and phosphate, which are mixed together, which is also used for the controlling of fungus. Treatment with natural products from plants and herbs, allicin and related substances from garlic and onion extracts. Chitosan are the derivatives of chitin isolated from crustacean shells. Cinnamon extract, trans-cinnamic acid, trans-cinnamaldehyde and ferulic acid are 5-hydroxy-3-methyl-cinnamic acid are used. And the some more examples are clove oil and other herbs are thyme, star anise seeds, black and white pepper, plumbago, indigo, etc. These are some of the control measures against the growth of fungus.
Myself Mounica, here we go for the topic toxicosis. Toxins produced by the fungi are called mycotoxins, responsible for spoilage and subsequent pathogenesis in the consumer. Basic compounds involved are aflatoxins and mycotoxins. Yeast and mold are infectious in dairy products and are rare as their rate of growth and metabolism slower than bacteria. Thus, their growth is often stalled as the growing and predominant bacteria. Population uses up all the nutrients before the yeast and mold can begin to utilize. Foodborne fungal toxicosis is of two basic types, aflatoxicosis and mycotoxicosis. Fungi are hard to eliminate, thus prevention of contamination is the better option. Then we can go for the topic mycotoxins. Mycotoxins include a large number of toxins produced by different toxicogenic species and strains of mold. Mycotoxicosis is a common toxicosis caused by Aspergillus flavus, Aspergillus parasiticus, etc. They are pathologically classified as hepatotoxins, nephrotoxins, vomitoxins, and neuromusculotoxins, some of which are potentially carcinogenic and mutagenic. Aflatoxins, for example, is the most potent hepatocarcinogen and mutagen among mycotoxins. Aflatoxins is the group of mycotoxins. Many mycotoxins are resistant to it, thus their elimination in normal preparation of food becomes difficult. In the US, regulatory bodies have set their limits for aflatoxins in milk, that is less than 2 parts per billion. The source which mycotoxins can grow are soil, dust and contaminated foods. Many can have viable spores, especially before eat treatment. And we can observe in the table and the different types of toxins and the fungi produced by the toxins and the toxicity is caused. Like aflatoxins is caused by Aspergillus flavus and its toxicity is hepatocarcinogen. And then we can go for aflatoxins. It is a common type of fungal intoxications caused by the common molds, Aspergillus flavus and Aspergillus parasiticus, by virtue of their ability to produce aflatoxins. Aflatoxin can be present in milk as performed toxins, or it can be secreted in milk by the milch animals that has been fed with aflatoxins containing feed. Upon ingestion, the Aspergillus toxins are metabolized by milch animals and are secreted into milk in form of M1 and M2 that are also toxic to the animals. The different types of aflatoxins we can observe are Aspergillus flavus produced by B1, B2, B2A. Among them, B1 is the most abundant and most toxic of the aflatoxins, and G1, G2 and G2A toxins produced by Aspergillus flavus only are extremely stable, potent and exhibit very strong toxicity. Apart from being a highly carcinogenic carcinogenic. The recommended upper permissible limit of aflatoxins in food is 0.5 microgram per kg. The source in which aflatoxins can grow are aerial contamination and soil contaminated foods introduce more spoils in milk and milk products. The symptoms that shows which are affected with aflatoxins are liver hyperplasia, tissue hemorrhage and anorexia, hepatitis and finally death in animals. The vital organs like spleen, pancreas and kidneys may also be involved in aflatoxicosis. And after the detection methods to detect this are several methods have been studied to detect mycotoxins, particularly aflatoxins in food. This include solvent extraction of suspected food samples, TLC extract, SPLC and visualization it under a UV light or fluorescent light. Chemical tests and mass spectral analysis is done to identify specific type of mycotoxins. In the recent years, immunoassays and immunosensors are used for rapid and sensitive detection of mycotoxins from food. Thank you.
Prevention and control. Prevention and control of mycotoxins and aflatoxins is done by solvent extraction method. The inactivation of mycotoxins is done by suitable chemicals. These chemicals are ammonia, hydrogen peroxide and sodium hypochlorite, which are found to effectively eliminate the toxins. The fungal growth is prevented by using fungistatic ingredients and providing proper storage conditions. Detoxification of fungi by physical, chemical or biological agents is relatively impractical in dairy products. These are some structures of mycotoxins. These are aflatoxins B1, fumonisin B1, patulin and etc. This table describes about mold growth and their mycotoxin production. These are some molds, mycotoxins, optimum temperature and optimum water activity. Yeast in dairy products. Yeast usually cause spoilage in fermented dairy products since they can grow at low pH. Yeast spoilage manifests as fruity or yeasty odor and or gas production. Yeast can produce pink rods on surface of butter and they are responsible for lipolysis. They are also responsible for proliferation on surface of ripened cheese and off flavor. Proper cured cheese has low lactose, thus limiting the potential for yeast growth. But cultured dairy products have enough lactose for yeast growth. Yeast spoilage can also occur in sweetened condensed milk and butter. Mold spoilage of cheese. Growth of spoilage mold on cheese is a problem which still has significance, though it dates back to prehistory. They grow on surface in large number and visible as fluffy growth. The most common mold found on cheese is Penicillium species, with other occasionally found including Aspergillus, Alternaria, Mucor, Fusarium, etc. Penicillia is commonly isolated from processed cheese, including Penicillium species. Vacuum packaged cheese support the growth of Cladosporium, Cladosporidia and Penicillium species. Controlling mold spoilage. Yeast and mold that spoil dairy products can usually be isolated in processing plant or packaging equipment in air, salt brine, on manufacturing equipments and in general environment. Successful control efforts must start with limiting the exposure of these products to the source. Most mold spores do not survive pasteurization. Packaging to reduce oxygen, cold storage, use of antimycotic chemicals like sorbate, propionate and nitamycin. The ability of some molds to degrade sorbate explains why cheese with high level of mold contaminations are not effectively preserved by this additive. None of these controls are completely effective. Besides spoilage, fungi are also used in manufacturing of dairy products. fermented milk products. These products undergo lactic acid fermentation and alcohol fermentation, which is performed by yeast. Blue cheese, it's referred as Roquefort, which requires Penicillium Roquefort for development. Camembert cheese, a type of soft cheese which requires Penicillium Camembert for ripening and distinctive taste. Bloomy rind cheese, Geotrichum candidum, is used for production. Some fungi are important in development of surface ripening soft cheese and semi-hard cheese because of their synergistic relationship with Bravibacterium lignin and Mycobacterium and lactic acid bacteria. Thank you.